children. Hope you are doing very good, safe at home. I hope all these video sessions are helping you to understand the concepts. Hope you all are writing their notes. Okay, today we will start with a new chapter, number systems. Okay, in this chapter there are a lot of new concepts that you will understand, and they are very interesting too. So we will start with what are the number systems that we have already learned in the earlier classes. So first, natural numbers. When we say natural numbers, these are the numbers that we use for counting. 1, 2, 3, 4 and goes on. These dots refer endless. They go endless. So it starts from 1. So 1, 2, 3, these are the set of the numbers starting from 1. What are whole numbers? So the natural numbers along with 0. Right? These number systems we have already learned in the earlier classes. We will just recall them. When we say integers, along with these whole numbers, the negative numbers are also included. Right? 0, the positive numbers on the right hand side, and the negative numbers on the left hand side. Right? So these, on both the sides, infinite numbers are included. So this is a set of integers which includes 0, positive numbers and the negative numbers. Next, we will go to real numbers. So what are real numbers? These are the numbers which include rational and irrational numbers. Rational and irrational numbers. What are rational and irrational numbers? So, real numbers include rational numbers and irrational numbers. What do you mean by rational numbers? Rational numbers are those which can be written in the form of P by Q. Rational numbers are those which can be written in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0 and P and Q are integers. They are not only integers, they are also coprime. What do you mean by coprime numbers? So we have already learned what is rational number. We have done addition, subtraction with rational numbers in the earlier class. We will understand what do you mean by P and Q coprime. Coprime numbers are those which do not have a common factor other than the number 1. For example, we will take 2 and 3. 2 and 3. What are the factors for 2? It is 1 and 2. What are the factors for 3? It is 1 and 3. So what are the common factors for these two numbers? It's 1. The other factors are 2 and 3, which is that they don't have a common factor other than 1. Therefore, we can call 2 and 3 as coprime numbers. Any other example we will see. 3 and 7. What are the factors for 3? 1 and 3. What are the factors for 7? 1 and 7. So, in these two factors, other than 1, we do not have any other common factor. So even 3 and 7 are coprime numbers. What about 4 and 8? What are the factors for 4? 1, 2 and 4. What are the factors for 8? 1, 2, 4, 8. So what are common in these? 1. What about 2? Even 2 is a common factor. Therefore, other than 1, they should not have any common factors for coprime numbers. So we cannot call 4 and 8 as coprime. So in rational numbers, we understand that P and Q are coprime numbers and Q is not equal to 0. For example, 3 by 5, 2 by 3, 7 by 11. So P is 3 and Q is 5. Q is not equal to 0. You see all the denominators, they are not 0. If it is 0, what happens? 3 by 0, 2 by 0, 7 by 0. What are these numbers? We do not know the value of these numbers. They are actually indeterminate. That is, they do not have a definite value. Indefinite numbers. Indefinite values they give. Therefore, the condition Q is not equal to 0 is important. So now, where are these rational numbers? Where do they exist on a number line? So we know where are the natural numbers, whole numbers, integers. Where are these real numbers? So real numbers, we will complete irrational also. What is irrational number? Numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. And again, Q is not equal to 0. Numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q are called as irrational numbers. So where are these real numbers existing on a number line? We will see that here. In natural numbers, consider the number line. Here is 0. What about natural numbers? Where do they start from? On the right hand side. Right hand side of the 0, that is, it starts from 1, 2, 3. These arrows indicate, what do these arrows indicate? That is, it is infinite. And here, so natural numbers lie on the right hand side of the 0. Where do whole numbers, how can we represent whole numbers on the number line? Including the 0, right? So these are natural. And including the 0, there it is. Whole numbers. Next, coming to integers. So we will include even the negative numbers. So the whole set are integers. What about real numbers? Where are these real numbers on the number line? Where do we represent and where do we get these? Just consider 1 and 2. Number line here. We will only zoom in only this part, that is 1 and 2. What are the numbers in between 1 and 2? This is, we know that it is 1 by 2. Sorry. 1 plus 2 by 2, that is 3 by 2. Which is nothing but in decimal, we also know that it can be written as 1.5. So what is this 3 by 2 here? And what are the numbers in between 1 and 3 by 2? This is 3 by 2. What are the numbers between 1 and 3 by 2? And what are the numbers between 3 by 2 and 2? So they are all in the form of fractions. And they are all in the form of P by Q. Which are called as rational numbers. Where are these irrational numbers on the number line? Even the irrational numbers lie between the rational numbers. It is between the rational numbers as well as it is between the whole numbers. So they all lie on the number line, which includes natural, whole and the integers. So we can say that all the numbers which come on the number line, which are represented on the number line, includes real numbers. Here we have find 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. 1 and 2 are whole numbers here. And it can be written as rational number also, 1 by 1 and 2 by 1. So we need to find 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. How do we do this? So generally there are two methods. 1 plus 2 by 2. If you consider this as R and S, R plus S by 2 will give you the mid value, so we can find a rational number. Again, subsequent finding subsequently, if you find the mid values, you will get the rational numbers. But there's an easy method to find, because there are five rational numbers. We can easily use this method. So what do we do is, since we need five rational numbers, add 1 to it. 5 plus 1, which is 6. So we need the rational numbers between 1 and 2. So we will take this number 6 as a denominator and multiply with 1, which is 1 into 6, 6. And here, for this 2, for both the numbers, we will take 6 as a denominator. How did we get 6? We need 5 rational numbers. Add 1 to that, we get the number 6. So that becomes the denominator for both. Okay? And then multiply 6 into 1, 6. 6 into 2, 12. So 12 by 6 again gives you 2. 6 by 6 again gives you 1. Therefore, now we need to find the rational numbers between 6 by 6 and 12 by 6. Just by adding 1 to the numerator, we will get the consecutive numbers, which are rational numbers between 1 and 2. How do we get that? 6 by 6 and 12 by 6 are the extremes, the limits. So here we just add 1. We increment the numerator by 1. 7 by 6, retain the denominator, increment it by 1, just by adding 1. 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6 and 11 by 6. So these are the 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. You can write rational numbers are 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6 and 11 by 6. We will do the next problem. Find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So how many numbers? 6. 6 plus 1 will give you 7. This becomes the denominator for the rational number. Write the limits 3 and 4. So 3 can be written as, the denominator becomes 7. 7 into 3, 21. Here for 4, 7 is the denominator. 7 into 4, 28. So we need to write the numbers between 21 by 7 and 28 by 7. How do we write the numbers? Just by incrementing 1 to the numerator. That is 22 by 7, 23 by 7, 24 by 7. Since we need 6, we will write up to 6. 25 by 7, 26 by 7 and 27 by 7. There are 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Rational numbers. Similarly, we can find the rational numbers between, if you have a question like this, find 3 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Denominators are the same here. So this is in the fraction, it's in the form of a fraction, right? It is in the form of a p by q also. So 3 by 5 can be multiplied by 10. Multiply numerator and denominator by 10. So you get 30 by 50. Multiply 4 by 5 also by 10. Numerator 10. Multiply numerator by 10 and denominator also by 10. You get 40 by 50. So now to get the rational numbers between 30 by 50 to 40 by 50, what do? We increment it by 1. 31 by 50. 32 by 50, we need only 3 rational numbers, 33 by 50. So they will surely lie between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5.